Good evening, and I welcome you students. We are solving important questions, MCQ questions for the first term exams, which is going to be held in November. Students, before we begin the session, we have few minutes of warm up exercises to release the stress, stiffness, and to improve our energy levels from the body. Students, sit comfortably on the chair, feet touching the ground. Start with Bhastrika. Inhale up, exhale down. 10 rounds. Start. All right. Shoulder. Release the stress from the shoulder rotation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, come back. Open and close your hands. Inhale, exhale. 10 times. All right, come back. Neck rotation. Right. Inhale. In exhale, inhale, exhale, right, left, right, left, up, inhale, down, exhale. Neck rotation, half clockwise, 3 times, anti-clockwise, 3 times, half inhale, half exhale. Okay, come back. Tap your feet on the ground 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I hope the energy is higher. Stress released from the body. A lot of students are exhausted, tired due to overwork. We want to remove that. Now we can do a breathing technique in order to relax our mind, quieten our mind, delete the thoughts in our mind so that we can focus better. What we can do, students, we can do along below 3 rounds. What we will do, you can see that I will close my right nostril, inhale from the left and exhale from the right. Then inhale from the right and exhale from the left. Okay, sit comfortably, feet touching the ground. Relax, relax your body, observe your breath. Start. Inhale from the right. Exhale from the left. Inhale as deeply as possible. Last round. Come back. Observe your breath. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Hold your hands. Attitude of gratitude is very important. Very important. We are thankful to the God, thankful to the universe, thankful to the environment for the gift of life and all the good things we have, students. Attitude of gratitude. And we are doing our best. Rub your two hands. Lower faster. Healing energy is produced. Heat energy is produced like a field of the magnet. Put it on your face. Let the field of the magnet go and heal your entire body. Keep inhaling, exhaling, inhaling, exhaling. Gentle massage your face, forehead, face, neck, head. Release all stress, pain, misery from the body, students. And now you may open your eyes with smiles and 3 claps. 1, 2, 3. Okay, come back, students. How do you feel, students?
वेरी रिलैक्स्ड.
ओके देन इट्स अ गुड थिंग दैट वी इम्प्रूव योर एनर्जी लेवल्स. नाउ वी ऑलवेज सेट अप एन इंटेंशन दैट आवर इंटेंशन इज टू डू एम सॉल्व क्वेश्चंस एंड द टारगेट वी सेट अप द टारगेट इज देयर विल बी एमसी क्वेश्चंस ऑन मोशन. एंड स्टूडेंट्स यू ऑलरेडी नो अबाउट द मोशन. व्हाट इज मोशन? यू नो इट इज अ चेंज इन पोजिशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट विद टाइम. एंड वी स्टडीड टू थिंग्स. What we studied, distance and displacement. What is the difference between distance and displacement, students? Important question. That question is coming so many times in the revision or recap, student. We talked about distance and we talked about displacement, student. What is the difference between the two when we talk of motion?
The distance is the total distance traveled by the objects from initial position to final position, and displacement is the shortest length measured from initial position to final.
Okay, all right. And then we discussed, student, that there are two types of motion. We said uniform motion. What is the uniform motion, students?
When object covers equal distances in equal intervals of time.
So what will happen if object covers equal distances in equal intervals of time? What will happen to its velocity? What will happen to the velocity? Will it be constant or it will change? Velocity will remain constant if the object has uniform motion. And velocity will keep on changing if it is a non-uniform motion. So here the velocity will change. These are some of the things we already know and important points, students. And what do we talk of? Acceleration. What do we talk? We talked of speed and velocity. What is the difference between speed and velocity?
So speed is scalar quantity and velocity is vector quantity.
So what is, how do you define speed?
Speed is the distance covered by an object in unit time.
And
what is velocity? Is displacement covered by an object in unit
time. Displacement by time. I mean, I'm putting an arrow. It is a vector that it has a direction, and this is a scalar quantity. It has scalar and vector. So velocity has both direction and magnitude. It has only magnitude. This is the difference. The acceleration. What is an acceleration, students?
Sir, acceleration means rate of change of velocity with time.
Okay, and we have given you important equations of motion. What are the important equations of motion?
V is equal to u plus at. S is equal to half ut plus half at square, and 2as is equal to v square minus u square.
Okay, these are some of the equations which are giving the relationship between velocity, distance, time. Now, what is important thing about circular motion? What do we talk about the circular motion, students? What do you mean by circular motion? Circular motion. What did you see the circular motion? If an object is moving like this, so what happens then? If this is a radius, then if athlete takes t seconds, okay, to go one round, then what is the speed of this? So we have already discussed when objects moves in a circular path with uniform speed, its motion is called uniform circular motion. And you have seen these are some of the things which we have already discussed in the chapter of the motion. So we are expecting that whatever questions will be asked, students, MCQ questions are being asked. These are assertion questions are being asked. Paragraphs are given. Answer the question. Question could be put in many forms in the exams. So we must get prepared. So we try to understand every question so that it gives us a very good and solid reason of the topic also. All right, I hope we can begin our session now. We are having a question. Student, a particle is moving in a circular path of radius r. The displacement after half a circle would be okay. You have 1 to 2 minutes. Don't answer, don't guess any question. Try to answer, try to solve the question, then you will be able to do it, students. If you will try to guess it, then we will have serious problems.
Sir, option C, 2R.
Option C?
Yes.
Option C. What is happening here? If I consider a circular motion, how do I say a circular motion, student? This is an example of a circular motion. A particle is moving in a circular path of radius is r, student. The displacements after half circle. Half circle, what is half circle, student? So if it is at A, this is going to B, that is half circle.
Yes. Right? Yes, sir.
So if this is r, this is also r. So from A, the particle has gone to B. A to B, student, r. Diameter, which is equal to the diameter of the circle. How much is that?
2R.
2R. Okay, that is the correct answer, students. So if the question would have been he comes back to his original position. If the particle comes back to A. Okay? Then what is the distance covered? And what is the displacement? What it will be our answer, student?
Sir, distance will be A plus B and B plus and A plus A, AB plus BA.
AB plus BA. How much distance he has covered? How much he has gone, student, this around the circle? What is that?
Circumference.
What is the circumference of a circle?
2 pi r.
Then 2 pi r. Circumference of a circle. What is the displacement?
Zero.
Zero, because he returns back to the original position. He returns back. The original position. This is the important point, student. Then displacement is zero. So we can see that displacement is equal or less than always the distance traveled by a particle. Okay. Questions could be changed in the paper. They can be put in any form. There is no guarantee that this question is coming, but question is of this type. A body is thrown vertically upward with velocity u. The greatest height h to which it rises is greatest height which it rises to, students. What will be the answer? What is happening, student, in this case? This is a body, this is thrown vertically upward. H is the greatest height to which it goes, students. Body is thrown vertically upward with velocity u. And the greatest height velocity, initial velocity is u, students. What is the answer coming? At the greatest height, what will be the final velocity?
Zero.
What is that? V equal to zero at the height, at the greatest height. Because it will stop then, which is our h here. What formula we are using?
Sir, we can use 2ah is equal to v square minus u square.
V square minus u square is equal to 2as, or here, what is s? Height, a is g. Then what will be it? 0 minus u square is equal to 2gs. The greatest height to which it will travel, student. Now, what will be in this case? Tell me, what is the answer coming?
U square by 2g.
Because a will be equal to minus g. Why? The body is moving against the gravity. When it falls below the gravity, it becomes plus. So what is this? Minus u square equal to. Then what is the value of s? U square by 2g. Which is the correct answer?
Sir, option B.
B. We have to think before we answer the question. Questions will require some thinking, and we have to solve. Don't answer any question without doing it. Most of the time, our answers will be wrong. There are three equations of motion which we have told you. They will be used. The definition of distance, displacement, velocity, scalar quantity, all these are going to be there. Acceleration, uniform motion, non-uniform motions. Questions will be of all types. Another question is coming. The numerical ratio of displacement to distance for a moving object is. Okay, you have about 2 minutes to answer any question, solve it, and then give the answer. Okay, I will say water, heal me, and I will sip water.
Sir, option B, always equal to 1.
Sorry, what will be the right answer?
Option B.
Why?
Sir, because take ratio, then since object is moving, both will have same value, distance and displacement.
Equal to 1. The numerical ratio of displacement to distance for a moving object is always equal to 1. That answer is not correct. It's always less than 1. What is the displacement by distance ratio? That is what we are asking. If an object is moving, student, what is he gave with the direction of the easy, the object moving in a straight line, the object could be moving anywhere. Object goes like this, then it goes like this, and what happens? It goes like this, is moving, it is not stopped. Did he mention anything about the motion of the object, student? Object could be moving in straight line or it could be moving in any direction. Then what will be the answer? This is not a correct answer. This is not a correct answer. What is the correct answer?
Equal or less than one.
This is also not a correct answer. So this is not a correct answer, students. This has to be either, if the motion of the object is this, then displacement is this. This is a displacement. You can see it is more distance is more, displacement is less. If it moves in a straight line, then displacement and distance will be equal. If object moves in a straight line, A to B, okay, then what happens? Distance is equal to displacement. But if object moves, does not move in a straight line, okay, it moves in a zigzag manner, what will happen? If object does not move in a straight line, then what happens? Displacement is always less than distance. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
The correct answer will be D then. D is the correct answer. Correct answer is wrong. As I said, students, you have to think before you answer the question or our answer will be wrong. Do not answer any question without doing it. Questions will require some amount of thinking. Mm-hmm. If the displacement of an object is proportional to square root of time, then the object moves with. Again, think about it before you answer the question. Don't answer any question in a hurry.
Sir, uniform velocity, option A.
Uniform velocity? How? What is it? If displacement S is proportional to T the square. See that? Object moves with. What is then change in distance per unit time? What do we say? What is velocity then? What is velocity, student? What is velocity? Distance by time? Displacement by time. Then velocity is proportional to t because it is t square. Yes?
Yes, sir.
So velocity, I'm saying, is equal to t square by t, velocity is proportional to t, and then what happens? What is acceleration? Rate of change of velocity with time. What will be that? Acceleration will be what, student? A constant, not the velocity. Then uniform velocity answer is no. What is this? Acceleration is constant means what? Uniform acceleration. Then, which is the correct answer?
Option B.
Option B. Answer is B, student. Uniform acceleration. Uniform acceleration. Okay. Now you got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Moving to the next question. As I said, student, don't answer any question without doing it. We will be landing in big trouble. For a given V by T graph, it can be inferred that object is here. Graphs are very important because there will be questions on graph, students. You know, different type of shapes of the graph, which we get equation of a straight line or some horizontal lines, you are getting all those. But what the graphs indicate to us, what is the meaning of the graph? Do not answer the question in a hurry. Take your time, then answer the question. You are given velocity by time graph, that the object is in uniform motion, at rest, in non-uniform motion, moving with uniform acceleration. What is our answer, student? Oh, water, heal me. Water is a great healer. I sip a drop of water and water heals me. Okay. Our purpose is that you should think, and then answer the question. Nothing to be answered in a hurry. That those answers will not be correct. And students will lose marks in the exam. What is happening here? Velocity versus time. What is this means? Horizontal line means what? What it means, student?
Sir, velocity is constant.
What it means when velocity is constant? When is the velocity constant, student? When will be the velocity constant?
Sir, when there will be no acceleration.
No acceleration. Where is the answer in the anything about the acceleration here? There is any acceleration answer here. Four choices are given. So what is the correct answer here?
Sir, option A, in uniform motion.
Uniform motion. What is a uniform motion?
Sir, when object covers equal distance in equal intervals of time.
When object will cover equal distance in equal interval of time, what will happen? The velocity will become constant. V is constant, so if we will make a graph of velocity and time, it will be a horizontal line like this, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
All right, A is the correct answer. At rest, no. In non-uniform, no. Moving with uniform, that is also not correct. So the only answer is A. But whatever choices are given, we have to find the correct answer out of the four choices which are given. Therefore, only the answer comes A. That is the correct answer. Next question is coming, student. Suppose a boy is enjoying a ride in a merry-go-round which is moving with a constant speed of 10 meters per second. It implies that boy is... What is a merry round? We have seen merry round. Merry go round. What is a merry go round? We have seen those type of like this. ठीक है? वो झूले से लगे होते हैं ऐसे ऐसे ऐसे. Boys, they are moving like this. what will happen? Speed is constant. How much? 10 meters per second. What did it mean, students? Think about it. What is the correct answer? The speed is constant. What happens then? Your time is going out. The speed is constant, students. What is the answer? Yes or no? Okay, then we proceed further. Speed is constant, but direction is changing. Then what it means? Is the velocity same or changing?
Sir, velocity is changing. Option C will be correct.
Velocity changes. And if velocity changes, what happens? At rest, no. Moving with the uniform velocity, no. Then in accelerated motion, the Y is in, answer is C. The Y is in accelerated motion. Because the velocity is changing. Velocity is not constant. Velocity is changing because the direction of the y is changing. Area under V by Vt graph represents a physical quantity which has the units, which has the unit. Draw the velocity and time area. What it means? You have drawn certain graphs, I said, in the this chapter, important graphs for drawn student. When you draw velocity time graphs, what happens? What will be the units?
Sir, meter.
Velocity versus time graph. If I draw that, what do we get in the velocity versus time graph, students? Velocity versus, if object is having this, so what we get? If I say this and this points, supposing A, B, C, D. If I see the velocity, but this area, if I want to see area A, B, C, D, what it will give me?
Magnitude of displacement.
So it gives me magnitude of the displacement. So what is that, units of that?
मीटर
डिस्टेंस और व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस डिस्प्लेसमेंट दैट यूनिट्स विल बी मीटर्स एम व्हाट इज द करेक्ट आंसर Answer B, M. M means meters. Okay. But he says, read the question carefully. Four cars A, B, C, D are moving on a leveled road. That distance versus time graphs are shown. Choose the correct statement.